Okay guys, so this is going to be the second method, and this is going to be called Facebook prospecting, right? And it is what it is. You're actually going to reach out to your leads and actually prospect them. Okay, so number one is you're going to reach out to your leads. You're going to either do this, you're going to private message your active friends who are super interested in building online business, right? So that's why guys, it's very, very important that you keep continuing to add people, add friends who are interested in what you're doing, right? Interested in what, interested in online business, interested in affiliate marketing, internet marketing, so on and so forth, okay? Number two, guys, is I want to emphasize before you actually go out there and start spamming your link and start, you know, hard pitching to these friends of yours, is to make sure you treat them as a real friend, right? So just imagine you and a mate at a bar, right? You know, oh, how's your day, mate? Oh, yeah, not bad. Start talk. Oh, you know, I came across this ad. Oh, yeah, what about the ad? Oh, this ad talked about, you know, real estate. Oh, what do you reckon? Oh, real estate, yeah, I heard about that. It's basically, you're actually gonna be talking to them as if they are your friend, right? You don't say, hey, thanks for accepting my friend request. You wanna make money online? Check out my link, right? As in, you don't do that. You don't talk like that to a friend. And for some reason, people think that's the way to go about prospecting on the internet, just because you're not face to face, right? And if you do that, you will fail. Nothing's gonna work, okay? So you wanna put the focus on, focus the topic on them, right? Ask about them and their interest and never spam them with your link, okay? Number three is you want to build that rapport. Again, you know, imagine you're at the bar, you're drinking, and there's a guy next to you, and he's like, oh, mate, you know, nice drink, you know, whatever, watching the sport, start talking, you know, oh, how's your day, how's your job, my job sucks, yeah, cool, this, that, you know, want another beer, so on and so forth. And you want to build that rapport, you know, genuinely talk to them as if they are your friend, and try to find some common grounds. Oh, you know, you like sport? Yeah, I like sport. What sport do you like? Soccer? Yeah, me too. What team you go for? Whatever it is. Manchester? Yeah, me too, mate. And just keep talking, so on and so forth. I build that rapport, right? And then after that, after the rapport has been built, you want to ask them for permission to share what you're doing, okay? Again, once rapport has been built, right? Once rapport has been built, ask them if you can share your business opportunity. So again, imagine I'm going to paint the picture for you at the bar, okay? And again, this could be at a wine tasting. It could be anywhere, right? Some sort of networking event, right? Think of it like that. Just visualize it at a networking event. How would you communicate with other people, okay? So with the bar example, rapport has been built. You know, start talking, I like sports, yo, me too. You got kids, mate? Yeah, I got two kids, so on and so forth. Hey man, you know, basically, you know, last Saturday I attended a seminar, and that seminar talked about, you know, basically making money through property, through real estate. It's pretty interesting stuff, mate. You're just wondering if you're into real estate, and that will give you an idea. Oh, real estate, yeah, man, I'm pretty interested, just don't know anything about it. Oh, cool, mate. Basically, it's pretty simple. You know, basically the seminar talked about this. Hey, you want more information? I can actually hook you up. Right, so you're just casually sharing your link. You're asking for permission. You know, do you want more? You know, can I give you more information? Stuff like that. You're not gonna be like, hey mate, here's my link. Bang, go to it, make money, right? Because that won't happen. They'll think you're a scammer, and they'll just unfriend you. And then basically, this whole Facebook method will not work. Okay, so again, number four is once rapport has been built. That's the key word, right? Ask them if you can share your business opportunity, which is your the document or whatever, your attachment, so on and so forth, that I explained to you in method number one. Now, number five is ask them to join your team. So now that you've shared it, right? Now that you've actually shared your link, you want to be more aggressive, okay? Because now that the, pretty much think of it as the cat's out of the hat, the bag, whatever it is, right? You want to be more aggressive. So you want to give them a reason to join your team. Hey, mate, basically share it to them. They're like, oh, cool, I'll check it out, right? So give it like 5-10 minutes. Hey, mate, what do you reckon? You know, have you had a chance to read it? Have you had the chance to look at it? By the way, if you do join my team, let me know so I can actually give you my bonuses. Hey, yeah, by the way, if you do join my team, you know, I'll give you extra support, extra coaching, whatever it is. You want to give them a reason to join your team then and there, okay? Don't let them say, you know, oh yeah, I'll check it out tomorrow, right? Just basically try and be more aggressive, because once you actually share your opportunity, the only thing left is to make sure that they follow the instructions of creating their account, confirming their account, logging in, so on and so forth, follow the instructions, okay? And you want to give them a reason and more incentive to just do that right here, right now, which is either a bonus, a mastermind group, your personal coaching email, whatever it is, okay? So how would you actually reach out to these leads? Well, there's three ways. The first one is new friends. Remember, I told you that you're gonna be adding new friends every single day, every single few days, every single week, right? Now, people will also be adding you as a friend as well, right? So it's either you accepted a friend request and you reached out to them then and there saying, hey, thanks for the friend request, I just accepted it, it's awesome to connect with like-minded entrepreneurs like yourself. Like, basically you can say that, but in this case scenario on the screen, imagine that you have just sent out a friend request and they accepted it, right? What you can do is, as soon as they accept your friend request, reach out to them straight away, right? Break that ice immediately. Thanks for accepting my friend request. I'm actually trying to connect with other online entrepreneurs and I can see that you XYZ. So basically you have a blog, right? Because when you go to their profile, most likely they'll be like, you know, a CEO of something, or the founder of something, or they own a blog, or they're part of this program. Find some common ground. I can see that you have a blog about affiliate marketing. I can see that you are part of a company called, Program X. I can see that you have, you know, made some money with Program X. And you basically just, you know, talk to them. It will be awesome to connect. And basically that is a breaking the ice type of reaching out, okay? And of course, you just keep talking, you know, oh, how's it going? How long you have been doing online business for, right? Again, this video here, guys, is not gonna be a full-blown sales strategy, right? Because there's many, many ways for you to actually close sales, right? I can recommend you to read, you know, How to Win Friends and Influence People, for example. I can give you a sales book, I can give you sales strategy, I can give you copywriting stuff. But the whole point isn't to make you the best sales person ever. The whole point is just to teach you this method, for you to apply it, for you to learn from it, and for you to master it, okay? And what I'm telling you right now, guys, is when you have a new friend, reach out to them, break that ice, and again, put the focus on them, okay? Remember, these are the five things. Put the focus on them, build that rapport, and you'll ask permission to share your link, okay? So, new friend, reach out to them straight away, right? Be awesome to connect, we can help each other. In fact, what are you doing right now, right? Can you share what you're doing? Can you share about this? Can you share about that? Put the focus on them, build that rapport, and then ask permission to share your link later on. Right, so if you have current friends, right, because here's the thing, you're not gonna be able to reach out to new friends every single time, especially if you're adding between 10, you know, 10 friends a day, for example. You can't reach out to 10 people every single day, not to mention people will accept your friend request at nighttime when you're sleeping, whatever it is, okay? So if you have current friends, right, and you see that they have posted something on their Facebook, okay? And if you see that they posted something very profound, if you see that they have posted like an ad or like, you know, hard pitch or whatever it is, right? You want to reach out to them, right? Be engaging, you know. Hey, Bob, I just saw your post and just wondering if you can tell me more about what you're doing. Because for all we know, Bob is like, you know, hey guys, I just joined a program, cool stuff. If you're interested, comment below. You can just comment below, you can reach out to Bob, you can do whatever you want, right? You can be the prospect yourself, okay? Because the more interest you have in what Bob is doing, the more Bob is willing to listen to what you're doing, okay? Because you're building that rapport. Don't say, hey Bob, I saw you promoting product X. In fact, my product is better, here's the link. Right, that would never ever work. Like, and I see people do this all the time. They just spam the link, okay? Just follow the five-step process, right? Follow the five-step process. Reach out to them, build that rapport, put the focus on them, ask for permission, and then ask them to join your team, okay? Now, of course, potential leads, right? This is something I don't see people do as often, okay? I don't even see people teach this, guys, right? So imagine, right? Imagine, okay? Bob, right? Bob is the person on his newsfeed that says, if anyone is interested in making $100 in the next week, I've got this cool opportunity. It's free to join. Comment below if you're interested, right? And so you saw that ad from Bob. So you can reach out to Bob and, you know, connect with him here. But on top of that, let's say, for example, 20 people says, Bob, more information, Bob, more information, more information, more information, right? Those 20 people are also interested in what Bob just posted, which means that they are also, they could be interested in what you can offer them, okay? So these potential leads that are interested in what Bob has to offer, you can reach out to them, right? You'd be like, hey Sarah, I saw that you were interested in Bob's program, in XYZ, whatever it is, okay? I'm actually very interested in it as well, okay? Again, common grounds. Just thought we could connect so we can help each other build an online business, right? Again, you're reaching out to connect, you're reaching out to build rapport, you're reaching out to have that relationship. You're not reaching out to pitch, okay? Build that rapport first, ask for permission, then you share your link, okay? So that is pretty much how this works, guys. Now, in terms of jumping over to Facebook and showing you how it's done, the truth is there is no point in doing that because it's just a matter of going on Facebook, right? Adding new friends, anyone who accepts you as a friend, bang, reach out to them and say something like, hey, thanks for accepting my friend request, XYZ, okay? Your current friends, if you see them post something, right, and you might be interested, reach out to them, right? This is prospecting, okay? A potential lead. If you see that other people are interested and they're not your friend yet, What you can do is add them as a friend. What you can do is also private message them as well, okay? The main thing, guys, I want to talk about in this video is this 5 steps right here. Reach out to your leads. Don't be afraid. Don't be a hermit. You're building online business for your whatever, why it is, right? For your kids, for your wife, for your husband, for whatever it is. Don't have that pride, ego, or shame, or embarrassment. They're holding you back. If you're here to make sales, then make sales. If you're here to prospect, and if that includes prospecting and reaching out to random strangers that are interested in building online business, then do that. You must do that, okay? That's why, guys, I don't want people to say, hey, Chuck, I tried everything, I don't make money, what should I do? Well, do exactly this. Prospect 10 people per day. Prospect 20 people per day. See whether you make money or not. See whether you can actually earn some commissions or not. I guarantee you will, guys. It's just a matter of how badly you're gonna hustle, okay? So reach out to your leads. Focus the topic on them, right? Focus the topic on them. Talk about them, talk about their life. You know, of course, you don't be like, you know, how old is your kid? What's your daughter's name? What school does your daughter go to? Else you're gonna be like a creep, right? You're gonna sound like a stalker, okay? So you're gonna put the topic on them, but still you're gonna talk about the online business, right? You don't be too personal is what I'm trying to say, okay? Build that rapport, and trust me, it's not hard. As long as you think of a scenario like at a bar, you're talking to like a random stranger, right? Or at a networking event, you're talking to someone that you just met, right? If you keep thinking of that scenario, then you can easily build that rapport, because trust me, you would talk as a normal human being and you're not there as a robot pitching your offer. Now, everyone does this, okay? Number 4 is ask for permission to share. And I don't actually mean, hi Bob, can I please have permission to share my link? No, you're simply saying, oh, there's this thing here, Bob. If you're interested, I can give you more information. Basically, just very subtle. If you're interested, I can give you more information. And Bob's like, yeah, sure, no worries. Fill me in. So that is permission, right? You're not gonna beg them for permission. You're just gonna subtly ask, hey, by the way, if you want to know more, I can let you in. If not, no biggie, man. Don't worry about it. Move on in life, right? And the 5th one is, of course, is once you actually share your opportunity, make sure to close the deal. Make sure they actually check the document, click on the link, and make sure they create an account and join your team and give them more reasons to. For example, if you have a bonus, if you have your own mastermind group, if you have your own coaching email, that always works, guys, because people want to join people that they know that they can get support from, right? And even if you're brand new, right, you can just say, hey Bob, you know, awesome, thanks for joining my team. One of the best ways I would recommend you get started is go through the 5-step process, and when it comes to traffic, just watch the Facebook method. That method really works, okay? If you have any questions, let me know, I'm here for you. That basic coaching there can go a long way. They'll upgrade to pro, elite, VIP, whatever it is, and again, because they are your referral, you make money. Okay, so that's it for this video, guys. Again, I'm not gonna walk you through exactly how to do this. I don't wanna, you know, type this and basically have like a real case and all that kind of thing. It's for you to understand how this method works, for you to go out there, hustle, learn from it, and basically just crush it, okay? So that's it for this video, and I'll see you in the next video.